Hello everyone and welcome back to another exciting unboxing video. And I want to say before I do the unboxing of this, I want to say a big thank you to Superstar for persuading me to actually think of getting this. And I'm just really looking forward to it. So, we are going to unbox R2D2 from Star Wars. Let's begin. Okay guys, this is R2D2, the Disney version. I went to the Disney store with my mother when we were up in Belfast and I got the R2D2. So before we unbox this, I want to show the back part of it, where it has two modes. Sorry for the lighting here. I need to see if I can get a better lighting setup, but basically it has two modes. The first mode is a button activation one, where you press the button and it'll go through the different sound effects. The second mode is interactive, so basically it goes by voice commands. And it also has a bump and go mode. It's similar to the BB-8. So we're going to unbox this, and I'm taking a leaf out of Fort Saxon's bit. I'm not going to let you suffer through the unboxing part of this. So I'll be back in a wee minute guys, as soon as I unbox this. This is R2D2 out of his box. I really wanted to get this here after watching Super Charles unboxing video. If you want to check that out, the video will be in the link in the description below. Please give him a check out, and if you like his videos, please subscribe to his channel. So, basically, it's a very, very good detailed for the interactive version. I've seen other ones I was thinking of getting, but I like this one here. So, how to activate him is the button here at the front, that when he's in the first mode, once you press that button, he will go through his different voice command, the wee voice unit. He has the wee sounds from the movie. It is screen record. It also has the holographic message of Princess Leia. Unfortunately, like I would love if the wee holographic bit here would work, but it's just her voice. Another exciting thing I found out about it when I was looking at the box, I don't know if Super Charles actually knows about this, but at the very top here, let me get the camera all set up, you can pop out the top part of his head, which Empire Strikes Back, it's the bit where he falls off the X-Wing and gets eaten by a monster. We periscope. I don't know if Super Charles knows that, but if he does, I hope this helped him. Back down here. So, at the very bottom here, it is the wee bump and go. I love the way that it's actually more hidden instead of the BB-8 version, because there's a massive button at the front and you can see it. But I like the fact that they can blend it in. So, how to change the modes on R2D2, right? So, at the very back, there are the modes. Now, I've set it to Satin 2, that's the interactive one. Satin 1 is just going through the different voice units. And then there's a Try Me feature. So that's basically it. Also, on the two here, two wee screws here, that is the battery pack. It takes 4 AA batteries, so people will understand. So what we're going to do now is we're going to have him on the ground to go through the voice activation parts of him now. Like I said, press the button to activate him, and that will be activated. So we're going to press him on now. As you can see here, that is an LED light feature. It has red and blue, just like the screen accurate R2D2. So we're going to put him on the floor now and we're going to go through his little activation things. So that is R2 moving now. So I'm going to test this here to show you that the bump motor does work. So you press the bump and go part here. If he bumps into the wall, you press it here. I think I'm on sound mode, am I? I don't. Oh, yeah. As you're going to hit the wall now. R2. It's also big loud noises. Thank you. So, pros and cons of R2D2. I have to say the paint apps are fantastic. It has that nice glossy effect as well. That's a good part I really like. It has all the details of the R2D2 from the movie. It also is, I love this fact that they actually put wires and stuff into it. It is a really, really nice. Pros, the cons on it, R2 doesn't like me saying pros and cons, but Super Sarah's video showed that it's very, very activated now. Maybe it's because I'm not very loud, can't pick up. But if you knock things down, you'll be perfectly fine. Now, like the bump and go motor here, I like the fact that it's blending in. That's my favourite part. It also has the nice wee wheel joint. It also has these little grips that they've learned from the last one, the BB-8 unit, that it was not the best. It kept moving back and forward. I also like the fact you can move these a bit. I love the feature that put it here at the side where you can actually pull up the periscope version. I love that. Now, I think I might do a little mod on it to make me weathering down. I'm not too sure. I probably do it. I'm not 100% sure yet. But it is very, very nice. Very good detailed. I like the glossy, shiny effect. So you can kind of say this is like the R2 from when he's all cleaned up at the end of New Hope. I also like the feature that put the LED light, the red and red and blue LED light. There really isn't any bad points to this here. The voice activation part's very good, and also the attention to detail is fantastic. The only thing I would love this to have would have been the little arms and attachments and stuff to come with it. That would have really set it off. But like I said, this is for kids. This is just for kids to run around and have fun. It's also fun to have them as well. But I'd love to have more details. Because I'm deadly for doing this, for modifying and stuff when I get it, I will probably do that, add the attachments and arms and stuff I got there. I have an idea to put magnets in the back of the body itself so you can attach wee things to it. That's for a different video. So, what's my opinion on it? It is fantastic. It's also very good. If you go into the Disney Store itself, it is £30. Online, it'll probably be about £45 to £50. I've seen some of them on eBay. On Amazon, I'm not 100% sure. I think it's around the same mark. But like I say, I really love this here. And I love the fact that now I'm almost have completed the collection. And what I mean by that is I have R2-D2. And I also have BB-8, which is, the Hasbro version is just the same height as R2. So the next guy we need to get is C-3PO. But yeah guys, that's basically it for this unboxing video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe and favourite. And I'll see you all in the next one. Bye bye guys.